Hello Norwich School, and thank you for joining this end of term video assembly. Usually, of course, at this time of year we would be gathering in the Cathedral to celebrate the end of term and turn our thoughts towards Easter. This year, of course, that isn't possible, but all the same we're going to do some of the same things now that we would have done if we had been in the Cathedral. So we have a reading, we have prayers, we have an address, and we even have some music. And we hope that all of this will help you to feel connected to the Norwich School community. We're going to begin with a Bible reading. This is one of the readings we have in the school hymn book, and it's read to us by Head of School, Angus Toms.
Philippians chapter 4, verses 8 to 9. Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you.
Many thanks to Angus for that reading. Some of you will recognise it from the joiners service. We choose it for its positive approach and encouragement to think about the important things in life, and I will return to that later. Welcome to number 16, The Close, and our unusual end of term service. We would all like to be in the Cathedral, I know, but I hope you will enjoy this marker of the end of term in our normal way. I hope you have had a positive week, and you've managed to maintain some momentum through to the end of term. I had the idea for this service at about half term, and I decided that I would follow up on Mrs. Fairweather's invitation for us to think about the five ways to well-being. Since then, of course, everything has changed, or certainly a good deal has changed. But reflecting on the points that are made in those five ways, they feel important still now, and I'm going to stick to the original format that I came up with. So let me remind you what they are: keep learning, be active, give, connect, take notice. Now, the first two of those, keep learning and be active, are the staple of a school. Certainly a school like ours, which sets much store by the holistic nature of our journey. I hope that even though the situation has been different, you have been able to keep learning and be active during this last week of term. The second two, give and connect, are very important to our community, but they are harder to sustain when we're unable to meet together in that gathering way that is so important in a school community. The school has continued to be open in order to provide supervision for the children of key workers and the vulnerable, and we are talking to local authorities about other ways in which we can be helpful as the situation develops. I'm sure that you and your families have been thinking of ways in which you can get involved in a positive way to help the wider community's response to the coronavirus. So they're important ways in which we all can continue to give. In terms of connect, I'm sure that you have been in touch with your friends and that you're using social media wisely and positively to remain connected. But it's the last one of these, take notice, which is the one that I wanted to concentrate on in my address today. The idea came from the Unplugged show, which is our evening at the Playhouse where pupils perform covers of other songs. Now, what I was going to do if we were in the Cathedral was to invite you to look around and find some colour. The Cathedral is a building that's known for its stonework and for its scale. But if you take notice, if you look closely, it is shot through with vivid colours. And even though we're not in that building, I invite you to have a think now about some colour that you can remember from that building. It may be the great west window. It may be some of the coverings for the altar. It may be one of the roof bosses. But just have a think about that building and take notice of colour in it. While you are doing that, I'd like you to listen to this song sung by Libby Hargrave. Thank you, Libby. That was beautiful. Apart from the obvious musicality and the emotional intensity that Libby brings to her performance, I liked it because it is so different from the original. Many of you will know You Somebody by Kings of Leon. After all, it is one of the most played rock songs of the last decade. But Libby has made it her own song. And she has changed it to the point that it made me take notice of it in a very different way. Now, I know that all of us would rather that we and the wider world were not facing the coronavirus and all that it brings. The pain and sorrow are on a scale that are sometimes hard to fathom, and the distress and the concern for us all is worrying. However, face it, we must, and I think the five ways to well-being are a good route map to navigating these difficult times, particularly as we contemplate a holiday that will be very different from those we normally enjoy. And I remind you of Angus's reading from the Philippians and its encouragement to be positive and to think about the important things of life. So keep learning, do retain your intellectual curiosity, keep going with your existing interests, and be bold in branching out and finding new interests. Be active, do continue to keep taking physical exercise to get your heart rate up. It's good for you, not just because of the physical benefits, but the wider benefits about the way that you feel about yourself. Think about those random acts of kindness, perhaps something you can do for your own family in the house, or for an elderly relative, or for the wider community. Connect. Do get in touch with your friends and family, but be wise about how you use it. Be positive about how you use it. Do not be dominated by it. And take notice. We are forced at this time to go slower than we perhaps would normally, and use the opportunity to look at things differently to get a fresh perspective. So, in conclusion, Luke Wright, the poet, talks about his hackneyed heart and the difficulty he experiences in reacting to the modern world because of its pace and intensity. Let us use this period to refresh our perspective and think again about the world around us. There is a lot less choice about the way we spend our lives than we are used to, and we all recognise how disconcerting that is. But remember that you are still the authors of your own life story. You can, as Libby has done, make the song your own. Do retain your sense of agency. Do continue to forge ahead with your own path. I close by offering good wishes to you and your families for the coming holiday. Good luck to all.
A prayer for the Easter holidays. Dear Lord, we pray for the world, for this country, and for ourselves. We pray especially for decision makers, medical staff, and key workers all over the world doing a difficult but important job. Please give them wisdom, courage, and success in what they do. We pray for all those who are ill or lonely or anxious. Help us find new ways of looking after each other so that we can ease one another's burdens. We thank you for our school community, and we pray for all the pupils, staff and families connected with Norwich School. Please keep us safe and well, and bless our homes, we pray. And Lord, we pray that the joy, the hope and the peace of Easter would break into these times of uncertainty, and that you would watch over us this day and every day. Amen.
I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun. I came down from heaven and I danced on the earth, at Bethlehem I had my birth. Danced and wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you in the dance, said he. I danced danced for the scribe and the Pharisee, that they would dance and they would follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They came with me and the dance went on. Dance then wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on the Sabbath and I cured the lame. The holy people said it was a shame. They whipped and they stripped and they hung me on high, and they left me there on a cross to die. Dance there wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on a Friday when the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. They begged for my body and they thought I'd won. But I am the dancer, I still go on. Dance then wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. They cast me down and I leapt up high. I am the life that will never, never die. A living you, if you live in me. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. Dance then wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
This is the blessing from the school hymn book that we would often use at Easter time. May Christ, who out of defeat brings new hope and a new future, fill you with his new life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.